Venezuela has gone teats up as years of socialistic corruption have taken their toll on a once rich country that now teeters on the brink of total collapse. Nicolas Maduro has had the oil-rich former paradise in a stinky headlock since 2013. And now, between the 10,000,000% projected inflation, that's a real number, medical brain drain, and civil unrest, the plucky 35-year-old National Assembly leader named Juan Guaido is ready to take the reins. Guaido appointed himself interim president, kind of like Hillary Clinton, with half the desperation and twice the self-awareness. And he has been recognized as such by the rational half of the world, including the U.S., and our adorable cousin Canada. It's obvious any Maduro electoral victory is a sham, but his opponent squashing and refusal to gracefully exit has created an odd dividing line with us, the Canucks, and most of South America on one side, and Russia, China, Turkey, and Cuba all on the other. And they can all suck it. Why would that dark alliance favor Maduro? Well, not only are they all die-hard, kill-easy authoritarians who love imprisoning and murdering dissidents, they also want access to those 300 billion barrels of dirty Venezuelan oil. Maduro is clearly corrupt and unpopular, but he keeps his boot on the neck of the poors through a series of sophisticated Cuban spy networks who tip him off to military members and others who would like to say adieu through a coup. The question remains whether the military will stay committed to an irrational maniac who can't support the economy or feed his own people, or if they'll switch sides and train their guns on the commies, finally forcing Maduro and his crony generals from power. Whatever happens, it is unacceptable to use military force from the U.S., as it would be immoral to create more Gold Star families and senselessly shed American blood on foreign soil. Venezuela is a failing cesspool, but they have not attacked us, and you don't see American tanks rolling through Nigeria and Sudan, where dozens of protesters there have recently been slaughtered. Maduro needs to go. There's no doubt about it. But the forces of freedom do not have to mean American bloodshed in order to see necessary and imminent change. And that's the memo.